very important rule of a group discussion is that most of the people do not know and are not aware of. Should we address the participants by calling out their numbers? Because each of the participants in a group discussion will always carry a number alongside to be able to identify that which candidate it is. So how do we address them? If you need to address them as a participant, please make sure that you can address them with using phrases like sir, ma'am, my friend, her, she, he, him. You can use up expressions like these rather than calling them out by numbers which may not really sound, and express yourself in a pleasing manner. The next important question is that do I take the permission from the group before I need to start the group discussion? The answer is, of course, without any doubt, no, never. Never get into a situation where you need to take a permission, because it may probably, you may actually look like as if you're weak and you need to take permission before you actually start speaking in a group discussion. And also, a general rule of group discussion is that it's always the rule of that who's going to be able to survive, who's going to be the fittest. It's all a game about that. So you need to survive. And you need to fight for that survival. So do not wait for a chance to come across your way. Another very important question to address is that in a group discussion, and it may probably also hold as a myth, that do they use it as an elimination technique rather than as a selection tool? So let me tell you, my friends, that a group discussion, yes, it is a foreground to be able to screen across the candidates and the potential on how is it that you behave and you show across your interpersonal skills and leadership skills. But at many a times, such acts will be used only as a basis of selection of the right candidate rather than trying to eliminate the junk from what you really need to take out towards the end. So be rest assured, be very confident that if you are good, you're confident and you know that you can be selected. Keep that in mind, be positive about it, that yes, group discussion is about selection, it is not about elimination. But yes, it may differ from institute to institute, from corporates to corporates, on what kind and the way that they look at it as a tool of selection or elimination. Now, this is a very interesting topic that I want to address here. And this is one of the biggest myths that I have been able to find across in a group discussion, that people say that the person who speaks the maximum, is he the one who is going to be successful towards the end? The answer is, of course not. That is only possible if the person who is speaking the maximum also has substantial and good quality content. So the reverse side is that the panel of judges are always looking and evaluating you on the basis of the kind of content that you have and you're delivering across amongst your participants and showcasing your ability to lead along with your interpersonal skills, which basically gets you the scores, rather than dealing and delving into a concept of quantity more than quality. So remember, in a group discussion, quality is always more important and given across a lot of leverage and points rather than quantity. Then again, a very important question is, are we allowed to carry a piece of paper when we're entering into the room for group discussion? See, normally you will of course be allowed to do so in many situations in corporates and institutions. You may also be provided with the pen and paper there at the situation of the group discussion. It's always advisable to be able to carry your own things, which is your pen and paper. In rare circumstances, they may ask you to be able to omit that completely and you may not really be required to carry it. But in most of the situations, yes, you will be allowed to carry these simple things along with you. Now, in a group discussion, a very important question comes across is that should we appoint a leader whom we feel will be able to moderate the group discussion in a better way? Is it all right to do so? The answer is, of course, no. The leadership in a group discussion is appointed and is actually seen in an implicit way rather than in an explicit way, calling up their names or by their positions in. If you probably know across the same participants who are sitting in the group discussion, never do so. Rather, be able to express yourself out and showcase your ability to lead, which could also lead you into that role of leadership. So never appoint another person to be a leader of the group discussion and take away that piece of cake from you easily.